Have you ever gone on a plane and had a pilot make an announcement like,
ladies and gentlemen from the flight deck, this is your captain speaking. I realize that we're leaving about 30 minutes late, but we're going to do everything we can to make that up in flight.
And you wonder, well, why aren't we just always arriving 30 minutes early if you can just make it up in flight? I'm going to explain it all. Coming up. Hey 7-4 crew, welcome back. If you don't know me, my name's Kelsey. I'm a 747 pilot. My channel, 7-4 Gear, is all about aviation. So whether you're a pilot or an aviation enthusiast, consider subscribing. In this video, I'm going to talk about how pilots make up time in flight when the flight is delayed for whatever reason. Let's get into it. There are really two ways in which the flight crew makes up time in flight. First is the airlines do something that I call overblocking. Essentially, if your flight is going to be 3 hours, the airline will put on the flight, you get on your ticket, and when you go to book your flight, it will say maybe 3 hours and 20 minutes or 3 hours and 30 minutes.
You sneaky bitch.
Every airline is different as far as what amount or percentage that they overblock. And that's to factor in, it could be a very busy airport, and on average over the last several years, there's been this amount of taxi time that's been allocated for that flight. So there's a few different ways in which they decide and come up with the algorithm, which I don't know how they do that, but that is something that I call overblocking. And they usually give themselves a little bit of cushion to make sure that you can make a connecting flight or so that they can get the flight in on time. The airlines are very precise in tracking the percentage of flights leaving on time, arrival time, all that stuff. They run it to the minute. So they really want to see how long and what time it's taking for the plane to arrive. They understand that their reputation of getting you out on time and getting to your destination on time is very important. So they track that. The other reason for overblocking, especially in the winter time that you'll have, is the de-ice process. That's if your plane has snow or there's snow outside, they de-ice the plane. And that's to make sure that it's safe for flight. Now that de-icing overblock is going to be in areas that are obviously used to getting snow. And if you show up and you're in, let's say, Massachusetts and it's January, which is used to getting a lot of snow, and there is no snow that day, you're probably gonna end up getting to your destination early because they will have overblocked that to allocate for the snow. The second way that the pilots make up time in flight is by flying faster.
I feel the need for speed.
Now every plane has a speed limit, so you can only fly so fast, and you may be thinking, well, why aren't we always just flying the fastest that it can go? And that's because just like your car, if you're driving your car at 100 miles an hour, and that's 160 kilometers an hour if you don't live in the US, if you're driving your car that fast, you're gonna be burning gas a lot faster and not making up that much time. So what may happen is the pilots will request additional fuel so they can fly faster, or the airline will let us know, we're putting on some additional fuel and we want you to fly this speed so you can get in as close to on time as possible. Of course, the faster you fly, the more gas you burn, and usually when the flights are laid out months ago, when they're planning out everything, they're planning the plane to fly at a more fuel efficient speed. So they usually will only do that when it's necessary or it's necessary for the operation. Of course, at the end of the day, safety is the number one priority of the airlines and for the pilots and flight crew. So we want to make sure that safety is the number one priority, but if we feel that we can get you there safely and make up some time, we will do that because we understand that you have schedules that you're trying to meet or that you have a connecting flight that you're trying to make. Hopefully this gives you a little bit of insight of what's going on the flight deck. In the comments below, let me know, have you ever had a flight leave delayed and then arrive on time and wondered, how is that possible? I look forward to hearing from you. Until then, keep the blue side up.